What's happening, everyone? Nick here from TV Box Top with a featured product review. We have now moved into the second generation of M.2 SSD enclosures that can now deliver up to 40 gigabits per second USB 4.0 data transfer speeds. The brand Akasys has released its version of this new generation of enclosures called the Akasys TBU45 Plus 40 gigabits per second SSD enclosure. So in today's video, let's look at the new design of this enclosure, how easy it is to install your SSDs, its USB 4.0 transfer speeds, and how cool it runs with its new cooling fan design. So my review begins right after this. And welcome back. In the box, you have the new Akasys enclosure, the TBU 405 Plus model. You get one 40 gigabits per second USB Type-C Thunderbolt cable, a pack containing rubber stoppers and SSD heat pads, and a user manual. So Akasys is known for using heat-efficient aluminum housing and easy access to their SSD slots. It comes with four ball bearings that snap open to access the M.2 SSD slot. The bottom cover houses a cooling fan that's powered by two connector pins when you reattach the cover. This enclosure also acts as a docking station when connected to a Thunderbolt or USB 4 port. To extend your displays by adding additional monitors, it comes with two 1.4 display ports. For connecting external storage, it comes with two USB 3.1 ports and a USB Type-C data port. At the front, it comes with a 40 gigabits per second USB Type-C port and a USB Type-C 5 volts power delivery port. Installing your SSD is quick and easy and require no tools for the process. Simply snap open the cover to access the M.2 slot. Insert your SSD into the M.2 port and gently press down, and using one of the rubber grommets, press it gently into the allocated hole for your SSD type. For this demonstration, I'm using a 2280 PCI Express 4.0 512GB SSD. For maximum performance, it's recommended that you use PCI Express 4.0 SSDs with this enclosure. Other SSD types will work, but they will yield much lower data transfer speeds. Once you've secured the SSD, you install the thermal pad evenly along the SSD for maximum contact with the bottom cover. And once this is done, you simply reattach the bottom cover, ensuring that it's lined up in the correct direction so that the pins for the cooling fan make contact. So you are now ready to begin using the enclosure, but to utilize the full potential of its docking station features as well as its data transfer speeds, you must use the included 40 gigabits per second cable or similar with the same rating. You also have to understand that to connect monitors via its 4.1 display ports, you need to connect the enclosure to a Thunderbolt port or a Thunderbolt adapter card that supports DisplayPort video pass-through. For connecting flash drives or external hard drives, you simply need a USB 4.0 port or Thunderbolt port without the need for DisplayPort pass-through. So to test the speed of this enclosure, the SSD I installed has an M.2 slot rating of 4,860 megabytes per second read speed and 2,590 megabytes per second write speed. So let's see in comparison to this rating what we get with this enclosure. So the results show that through this enclosure, it has a sequential read speed of 3003 megabytes per second, which is 38% slower than an onboard M.2 slot on your desktop motherboard. This is extremely fast compared to the first generation enclosures that could barely make 900 megabytes per second. So for a live file transfer speed test, here I downloaded a 116 gigabytes folder to the enclosure. and I will now cut and paste it onto my gaming PC onto a Samsung Evo 970 Plus 1TB M.2 SSD. It took approximately 2 minutes at an average transfer rate of 1.45 GB per second. I will now cut and paste the same folder from my PC onto the enclosure. It took approximately 4 minutes at an average transfer speed of 474 MB per second. So in summary, on my PC, I'm using an ASUS Thunderbolt EX4 adapter card, and when I connect the enclosure to it, the Thunderbolt control app detects it as a Thunderbolt device. The card supports PCIe tunneling, so any external storage device connected to the enclosure will be detected and you can access the data on the storage. Where the dual display ports are concerned, these will only work when connected to a Thunderbolt port or adapter card like the one I'm using, which supports DisplayPort pass-through for multiple connected displays. Connecting the enclosure to a regular USB Type-C display port will not activate the display ports. So that sums up this review of this new Thunderbolt USB 4 enclosure from Akasys. If you like this model, you can find it using the link in the description below this video. Thanks for watching. Give this video the thumbs up to support the work that I do on this channel. Don't forget to like and subscribe to receive notifications about open box deals, new videos, and giveaways. Thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Stay connected and see you in the next one.